Day in the life of a field engineer, building from the ground up. In this video, I'm going to talk about a day in the life of a field engineer and get you excited about what that looks like and discuss some of the really cool things that a field engineer gets to do if you get that opportunity, which I hope you do, and discuss how you can approach it in a way where you'll be ultimately successful. So if you're into that, and I hope you are, please stay with us on this video. All right, so field engineering is my jam. Like, I love this. I love the field engineering methods manual written by Wes Crawford from Purdue University. He's an emeritus professor there. And I absolutely love the concept of our industry going back to this and training future superintendents and project managers through the role of the field engineer. It is a key position. And in fact, this isn't like a dying art. This may have been a little bit of a lost art for a while the construction industry was mainly focused on administration. But now I'm seeing lots of, and literally lots is the right term here, of companies going back to it, large companies instituting the program or the position of field engineer in their companies. And so I'm really, really stoked about this. And before I begin, let me say that true field engineering is where an individual, a professional, is able to go out in the field and do layout and control, meaning establish layout control for the buildings from primary to secondary to working control. Enable the craft, perform lift drawings, meaning they're pulling information from multiple sources onto one set of installation lift drawings for that work package, and they get to do frontline safety and quality management. So that's the role. But let me take you into a day in the life of a field engineer. I'm going to give you the ideal and then joke around about it as we go, but let's go over here to our flip chart. So first and foremost, what I recommend day in the life of a field engineer, obviously you're at your house, you're waking up, you're taking care of your dog, you're eating breakfast, you're doing your morning exercise, whatever it is that you do. The key here is to do a morning routine. Really make sure that you have a good way to start the day and to get your mind centered on gratitude and giving and really get into a good mental headspace. So on the way to work, when you're driving to work, I highly recommend listening to books or podcasts. A really cool life hack or work hack is to listen to something like that that's like really gonna get your mind going on the way to work, and then listen to something entertaining, music, a fiction book, or something on the way home. This is huge. So once you have started your day at home, done your morning routine, listen to something that's educational, and I can give you references if you want. Just contact me anytime. Oh, in the comments below, you can just reach out. I'll give you some really cool information. But this right here is gonna do more to accelerate your career than almost anything else. Then when you enter the job site, now this is where the fun begins. One of the things that I love about field engineering is that when you're on site, you are able to interact with the project management team. You will have an office and you will be typically in the field engineer bullpen out in the open, in an open office space. This is where you will do two different kinds of planning. The crew or the FE group or team huddle, which is where you talk about the group tasks for the day and anything that's coming up, right? Do you need to request the professional surveyors? Do you need to call an inspection? Do you need to get ready for a placement? Is there coverage that you need for the day, right? So once you come in and park, you're gonna go into the trailer and do your team and your basically your FE group overall planning. Once that's done, and I recommend that that be on a timeline, right? And make sure that everybody is looking out ahead at least a week, but like I always say, 1 to 6 weeks out ahead to make sure that we're planning properly. Then it's time for you as a field engineer to go list out your to-do list and to fill out your personal organization system time block, which means that within the day, from the time that you got started to the end, time block the key activities based on the overall plan. So don't start the day until it's finished on paper or in whatever app you're choosing to use. So you're going to do your planning there in the office. One of the things that I really like to mention is that there's a great practice that I found, and it's tough if you're not an early morning riser, but it, you know, even so, consider it, meaning and consider it. Sorry, find a time that really works for you where you can get some peace and quiet. So the best thing that I found when I was a field engineer and when teaching field engineers is to literally come in at 4:00 or 4:35, right? Meetings, you know, morning huddles, and the busyness of the job site typically start at 6:00, 6:37, whatever it is. Come in a little bit early. And once you have planned your day, right, time blocked it based on the overall group plan, spend 30 minutes or an hour, minimum 30 minutes, doing your lift drawings. This is where you have quiet time to flip through your drawings or look at them on Bluebeam on the screen and to literally work in AutoCAD or Revit or Tekla or whatever program you're using and detail out those lift drawings. That really focused quiet time will save you so much, because if you're doing it during the day, it'll be, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need? And you'll lose focus and miss something. And we all know that with lift drawings, when we're combining information, we do not want to miss something. We want to work in a focus. Okay. Another thing that you can do in the morning when you're in the trailer, in addition to the lift drawings, is layout or control planning. This might seem a little bit silly, but you're going to print out your floor plans or your civil sheets that have your monumentation and any other layout that's established. So like I said, monuments with X, Y, and Z. So that means that you have a benchmark there as well. And actually look at the work that you're gonna lay out that day and create a drawing that really gets you to that layout accurately with the right double checks, right? A different person, a different approach, a different technology, right? A different perspective. And so if you have monuments up on the ledge and you're in the basement, right? How are you going to get lined down in both directions? How are you going to transfer your benchmark? How are you going to double check it? That should all be listed on your layout and control planning or your sketches that basically establishes the plan for the day. I would recommend having those sketches actually in your field book as well on the right side, so that when you actually do your data tabulation, you can just reference the sketch. But lift drawings and your layout and control planning are wonderful things to do before the day starts. After that, you will, on a project site that's being run in a lean way, come out here to the morning worker huddle. This is where all the workers gather from the parking lot to come get the plan for the day, to speak up, to get shout outs, and to align. So as a field engineer, you will be supporting the superintendent or assistant superintendents, or you might be actually delivering the morning worker huddle yourself if they're training you. But what we want to do is keep everybody corralled, forward, paying attention, and make sure that we're completely aligned. And one of the things that a field engineer will do is if they're working with a crew, and that crew after the morning worker huddle goes and huddles together, that field engineer might pace over there and connect with them and say, hey, this is what I'm working on today. Just want to see if you have any other requirements. So attending that morning worker huddle is key. Okay, now this gets into the fun part. So, and I do want to say that in the morning, you'll want time if you have like a Kawasaki mule or just a little golf cart or go-kart or even a truck. Some field engineers work out of a truck. Whatever the case may be, you'll want to load your equipment, make sure that you have all of the right information, maybe the installation work package, the lift drawings, anything that you need to go do your work for that day. Once you're done, and obviously you will have huddled over here to the morning worker huddle, I see field engineers go in two different directions typically. Okay, one is they'll go out and actually do layout, or they will do quality control, or they'll go do their safety walks. And obviously safety is first, it's a priority, it's always, right? But go out and actually like enable a crew. See, that's what field engineers are here to do, is to work with the superintendent and the foreman to prepare an installation work package with lift drawings, with layout, with everything that that crew needs so that that crew can be successful, okay? So typically I see that. Now, if you're out of the foundations, the structure and the masonry phase of the job, and you're all the way up through the superstructure, and now you're looking at wall framing and above ceiling inspections, or you're doing commissioning, you might be in more of a quality control and a production mindset and focus. So if you're out of the phase of doing layout, QC, and safety, then what you'll be doing is called zone control. Okay, And what this means is you are helping the project superintendents and the foreman to check zone handoffs where trade partners are moving into forward positions. Two, QC right then and there, plan out ahead, help the trades with problems, not because we look down on them, it's because we look up to them and we're supporting them, right? And so helping that superintendent to make sure the handoffs are happening properly is absolutely key. Obviously in here, you're going to have the QC role with in-wall inspections, above ceiling inspections, right? Anything that we need to check. And you're also gonna have that same safety focus. So it doesn't matter. People tell me all the time, you know, hey, we're not doing self-perform. We don't need field engineers. Yes, you do. I don't care if you've subcontracted the concrete, the masonry, and the structure out, you still have field engineers. And even when you're out of that concrete and masonry phase and steel phase, you're still using field engineers to help with quality in the field. You don't just need quality control during foundations and superstructure, you need it throughout. All right, so we're almost done here. Once the field engineers go do their primary tasks, they're going to finish up and button up, and at the end of the day, come back over here to the afternoon foreman huddle and be a part of that afternoon foreman huddle, working with the foreman, planning with them, enabling them, and making sure that they know the plan for the day. Once they know the plan for the day with the foreman, they'll go into their bullpen together and make a plan as a field engineering team for the next day. And like I said, go home, listen to something wonderful on the ride. It can be a personal book, it can be a podcast, it can be educational, but it could also be fiction. And then go home in a really, really, really good mindset, constrain your hours, and be ready to take care of your family and yourself. And that literally is the ideal day in the life of a field engineer. And in the description below, what I'm going to do is link you to a book called Construction Surveying and Layout, or otherwise known as the Field Engineering Methods Manual, and some other resources that I think you'll enjoy. But please reach out in the comments if you ever need any help with this. I hope you enjoy your life as a field engineer and that you've enjoyed this video. On we go.